please put your hands together. I think we should give him a round of applause for Captain Chaos himself, Mr. Richie Firth.
Come on out, Richie. Captain Chaos. Oh, wow. He's come from behind.
Let me take a little bit of time to tell you about Richard. Richard's just an ordinary child, an ordinary boy who was in love with his Uncle Ken.
Sorry.
He sees Uncle Ken at a family wedding. Uncle Ken has aged, but it's still all there. And he says to Uncle Ken by surprise, "Uncle Ken, it's me, Richie. Remember me. What is between Earl's Court and Hammersmith on the Piccadilly line?" And he cannot answer the question.
You're drunk.
No. Oh. He's aged. He doesn't.
Oh, sorry.
Excuse me, please. He's aged. He doesn't know anymore.
We're not really heckling, please, Christian.
Thank you. The answer is, of course, Baron's Court. And I then...
Of course.
Could you ask for a bit of silence, please?
Sorry, silence in the room, please.
Thank you.
It
was at that stage that I realised that I now had the knowledge and I was ready to take on the Underground. Millions of Londoners do it every day, ladies and gentlemen, but they only take on a couple of stations at a time. I want to take on all 270 in the quickest time possible. 16 hours, 29 minutes and 13 seconds is the current record that is established. I was going to take this record on today, but today was not the day, because I suddenly realised that in 2 weeks' time, it is International World Records Day. So, why not get together with our...
No, it's International Guinness World Record Day.
I was coming to that. Why not get together with our friends at Guinness for International Guinness World Records Day and do the record on that day?
Oh, Ken, I love you.
Myself and some members of the public have a concern about your level of fitness. We're just wondering if you're doing any cardiovascular training for the event.
A good question, Tom, and I'm quite happy to take it. Every day I catch the tube back to Hounslow West Tube Station, which is on the Piccadilly line. It's got quite a fierce flight of steps to get back up to street level, so I undertake them every day.
And at the top of them, isn't there that little snack shop?
There is, yes. It's called Premium News, yeah.
Richie, I'm sure you'll agree 16 and a half an hours is a long time. I've got to ask the question, what are you going to do about the loo?
A very good question, Andrew, and thank you very much for asking it. I've thought about this. I will be getting together with my friends at Imodium. And what I will be doing is taking a couple of their magic tablets at the beginning of the day, which should mean that I will be backed up and not having to visit anywhere. Now, obviously, that's not going to sort everything out. So I do have a radar key, which will access all toilets on the Underground, so provisions have been made.
What I'm worried about is where are you ending up after 16 of hours of Imodium?
Heathrow.
Heathrow. Yeah. There's going to be some sort of big detonation at Heathrow. Do we need to alert the security services?
We should be fine.
Okay. Thank you very much for your question. Charlotte, got one for you.
Richie, you're going to be mixing with a lot of the general public whilst you try and break this record. What can the public do to help you achieve your goal, and what is your message for them?
A good question and a simple message. Get out the way.
One last question then from Tom.
What proof do you need to provide the Guinness Book of Records to have the record verified?
That is a very good question.
And
I'll pass that over to Lynn.
Yes.
Lynn? Liz.
Liz, sorry.
Guinness World Records. Guinness World Records Day, 17th of November.
Indeed.
Lynn, off you go.
I will be there, as I said, from the start. So I'll be registering the timing for the record. That will be my job. I will be in touch with independent witnesses who will be with Richie throughout the day as well. And I'll be keeping close track on him via the information that's supplied to me from them. I might make scheduled stops along the way, but most importantly, I'll be there at the start and the finish.
So 6 o'clock in the morning.
Yes.
At Amersham. And then sort of half 10.
Well, it's got to be... By half 10 if I'm going to achieve this, Christian. Sorry, when I achieve this. So, yeah, Heathrow Airport, sometime just shy of half 10.
Thank you very much for coming, everyone. Thank you very much to Liz from Guinness World Records, Richie, Captain Chaos, thank you very much. And, of course, visiting lecturer
Andrew Bailey. Well done, students. Well done.